Good day, I'm Lorraine Mendez, and this is your JIS News for Tuesday, March 22. Jamaica's response to the introduction of the Zika virus is receiving high commendation from the Pan American Health Organization. A PAHO team was in the island last week and assessed the island's surveillance system.
They have said basically we're doing, for the most part, what we need to do to create the awareness and to track the possibility of the virus spreading.
The health minister, who was speaking at a press conference on Friday, said PAHO had also validated the newly established testing facility for Zika. Samples tested at the newly upgraded UWI Virology Lab will be validated at a Center for Disease Control reference lab in Puerto Rico. Dr. Tofton disclosed that PAHO had pledged continued support for testing at the UWI lab and at the lab in Puerto Rico.
With all of this, the public relation, the sensitization, the ministry's drive, the support from PAHO, WHO, the lab that is here that allows now for testing within a relative short period of time, I am fairly satisfied that there is adequate preparation by the country and the country's ability to respond, to deal with and to respond to the Zika virus outbreak.
The health minister is urging persons to protect themselves against mosquito bites and to visit their health care provider as soon as symptoms such as rash and fever are present. 20 health workers from Cuba are now in the island to help fill gaps in Jamaica's health services island-wide. The medical professionals arrived yesterday and will be here for the next 2 years. They are among 90 workers due to arrive this year as part of a technical cooperation agreement between Jamaica and Cuba.
We have had a number of doctors and a particularly higher number of dentists and orthodontists, we are particularly short of. And, you know, over the last couple of years, we have started to look to Cuba for this group. I'm also seeing where we should be having a biomedical engineer.
Yes.
Which is an excellent addition in terms of the maintenance of our equipment, our x-rays, our anesthetic machines, etc.
These professionals will be deployed to the regional health authorities. Plans are underway to keep students in the secondary school system until age 18. Minister of Education, Youth and Information, Senator Ruel Reid, made the disclosure, saying it formed part of measures to deal with the issue of unattached youth.
Because of the numeracy and literacy deficit, the majority of our children exited the system, some at grade 9 and grade 11. And then we talk about why we have this vast array of unattached youth. My dream has always been to ensure that no child is left behind. So all our students need to be engaged in the education system until they are age 18 and beyond.
Minister Reid was speaking last Thursday at the closing ceremony for the Partnership for Improved Reading Outcomes project. It's a joint initiative of the United States Agency for International Development and the Education Ministry. Still on education, students from 30 high schools across the island will be engaged in a live theatre production on the dangers of underage drinking. The project, dubbed The Movement, represents collaboration between the Education Ministry and beer company Red Stripe. Education State Minister Floyd Green says it falls in line with the ministry's policy against substance abuse.
We have been doing it, but we need support. It will take partnership to change culture. It will take partnership for us to have a different outlook and a different approach. And this sort of partnership that brings in corporate Jamaica, community, government, that is what we need.
The movement seeks to change youth attitude towards alcohol drinking and provide information on the causes and consequences of alcohol misuse. The program is also supported by the National Council on Drug Abuse and the National Parenting Support Commission. And finally, the Ministry of National Security has endorsed the Fight for Peace initiative, which uses sports to reduce youth violence. National Security State Minister Pernell Charles Jr. says the initiative will help Jamaica achieve Goal 2 of Vision 2030. The Jamaican society is secure, cohesive, and just.
This is one of the projects that will be so important in the larger growth agenda, because we have to start with small steps in order to move to the wonderful objective that we want for our country.
He was speaking at a function hosted by Fight for Peace and the Violence Prevention Alliance. Fight for Peace uses boxing and martial arts combined with education and personal development to realize the potential of young people in communities affected by crime and violence. 11 organizations in Jamaica have joined the initiative. And that's it for JIS News today. I'm Lorraine Mendez. Thank you for watching.